Hi, this is Gajengi Raja Babu, and today we are going to see in must know tactics. Under that we are going to see double check and as well as how to take advantage if opponent's pieces are overloaded. So double check and overload, which we are going to see in today's video. So guys, don't forget to share, like and subscribe if you really like the video. Now let's see in this position how to do a double check. Now let's see what are the advantages of double check. Normally when you give check to your opponent, he is always having three options. The one option is to capture the piece which is giving you check, and second option is to just interpose any piece in between the piece who is giving check. And the third option is just moving away the king. But when we give a double check, that time your opponent is left with only one option, that is just moving a piece or moving a king away. He will not get an option of to capture the piece who is giving check, and also is not having any other option of interposing anything in between. So he will be left with only one option, that is moving. So therefore the double check is very powerful, and here with the double check we are winning the queen, and later on we can simply win the game. Okay, and if you don't want to do that in this position, you can simply give check with the rook and you can even checkmate your opponent. Okay, now look at this position. Here also the double check is possible by just sacrificing his queen here, but you need that third eye to understand in which position the double checks are possible. Now look at, the rook is behind the knight. Okay, so here knight is there, here rook is there. Okay, so in such position, so you have to understand, and the king is absolutely weak here, so the black decides to give this queen free. So as it takes, now the double check is going to come and it's going to be made. So as I told you that the double checks are very 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 powerful, guys, very powerful. Now look at here also, like rook and bishop, and the queen is here. So here the queen is ready to get sacrificed. So queen sacrifice, king captures, and see, double check, and it's a simply mate. So the double checks are very very powerful. Now look at this position. Here the rook and the bishop are in the same line, but here the king is there, and in between this pawn is there. So therefore in this position the white's thought of giving his queen free. So just is giving away queen here, is giving check. So opponent captured with the bishop, and look at, he queen by capturing that bishop. So he captured with the rook. Now an interesting a double check will come by just removing this bishop. Bishop into pawn check, and it's a mate, because king was not having any place to move. Look at here also, like powerful queen and rooks are attacking this, you know. There is a big chance of giving double check. So he no need to get scared. Usko darne ki baat nahi hai. Even this bishop is going. So here the black is simply giving this check. After capturing this, now black need to take some time and to decide whether which check is going to good. Whether to give queen check is going to good, or whether the rook check is going to good. For that, he need to just think and calculate, like by giving which check, he will be checkmated soon. Okay, so in this position, I think the white king should get checkmated in three moves. I think the best continuation here, I believe, to give the rook check. If the king comes here, I think to give the pawn check. King goes back, and again the pawn check, and it is simply checkmate. The king got checkmated with that powerful double check. Now let's see, in this position also there is a chance of giving double check. But like, you know, the king is not, sorry, the king is nowhere in this particular file. So here the white decides to get the king here somewhere, so he is giving this check. Now let's see, if the king would have come here, then this bishop check and mate. Okay, so king came down. Now let's see, the double check is possible, but here there is a confusion. One is this double check is also possible, and second is this double check is also possible. So we need to decide which double check is going to be good. Okay, sorry, not this. So which double check is going to be good? So, like, you know, the king want to go here and he want to hide somewhere here. So, therefore, the white decides to give this double check. Because any which ways, here the king is not going. By capturing this, there is no use because this pawn is there. So, obviously, he will not go there. This check, he came here. Check. Knight came in between. Capture this. See, again, no option. Capture this. No option. Okay. Again, give check. He went there. Now, by making this queen, if he captures, capture this. He is having lone queen and we are having 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So, we are simply winning this position. Okay, so I hope you understood about the double check. Now, we are going to see a next tactics which is called as overload. Okay, now look at this position here. Overload means a one particular thing or one particular piece who is actually supporting two pieces. Now here this pawn is supporting, the bishop also supporting knight also, bechara, the one pawn is doing so much hard work, like he is overloaded by having two supports, supporting two things. So here we can simply capture this knight. If he takes this, if he would have taken that, then we would have taken captured with the rook. Okay, now look at this position. Let's see what is overloaded. Now here the white is simply made the battery of bishop and queen to just do checkmate. And also is threatening to give this pawn fork and attack two rooks. Okay, so here this knight is overloaded. Bechara is defending this also, is defending this also, is defending both. He is having overload work. So just do this. Now captured to mate, not captured, so we are winning the rook. Now here look at this position. This position is a very interesting position. Here it looks like, you know, nothing looks like overloaded, but a very important concept you have to understand here. See, this pawn just two moves away to become queen, only two moves away to become the queen. Okay, so therefore the white decided to just release the load by giving this bishop free. Suppose if he would have taken this, then the white would have pushed this pawn. After capturing, this pawn would have become queen immediately. So he need to, this bishop need to come to defense. The white is simply capturing. See, this pawn is overloaded because if he takes this, then this would have even become queen. Now white is simply winning because he got already two pawns up and he can easily win the game. Even by taking this king here, he will simply win and the game over. Oh, now this is like, you know, white to play. Let's see what is overloaded here. Yeah, I came to know what is overloaded. Because I think this king is back rank mate, this check and mate ka threat is there if this queen is not in this particular position. So now this queen is guarding this square also and guarding this square also. So basically the queen is overload. So to spot such position, you need a very good eye. Okay, achhi nazar honi chahiye to find out such tactics. Okay, knowing tactics is good. And implementing them in the game is a different thing. Okay, so you need a proper eye, you need to, you know, have a patience to think. So therefore here the white decides to just take this bishop. If he takes, checkmate. Now look at here, this is very interesting position. This king who is guarding this also and guarding this pawn also, is guarding both, so it is overloaded. So the rook takes this pawn. After capturing, he simply takes this. And now I think he takes this also. So this is almost all over. Now look at here. What is overloaded? What is overloaded here? Overloaded. I think this rook is overloaded, protecting this rook from the queen attack and also this check. Okay, so therefore I think the white decides to sacrifice queen. After capturing this, he will give this check. If the king comes here, see the bishop check. Okay, a bishop check, and now he will take this. And it is almost all that game is over for it. Look at this pawn wants to become queen, but this pawn is overloaded of supporting the rook and also blocking this pawn. Do job kar raha hai. So simply take this rook, capturing c. Now we can simply make queen and we will be having extra rook at the end of the day. Make queen and simply take this. So this is how you can take the advantage of overload. Okay, now this position also, in this position also, it's very simple. I think this pawn is overloading, because I think by after giving this check, if this king comes here, knight want to give check and take this free bishop. Okay, so this is what running in white's mind. White want to come here, give this check and take this bishop. Okay, so therefore he decides take captured. Now suppose if I give this check, he will come down. If I give this check, he will come here, and like if I take this, then he will take my rook. Okay, and suppose if I take his rook, then he will simply give me checkmate. So this is the idea. So therefore I think the first move we should play here, idea of giving Anastasia a mate. So see, now he saved himself from the mate. We are taking this bishop. Okay, so that is very good. Now here again the overload, like I think this check will be mate. So knight is protecting the back rank mate, and the knight is also guarding this bishop. So it is simply overloaded knight. This, if he captures, it is going to be, see, he gave the check, he will take this. He took. Now after capturing this, see, we are having two pieces, he is having one piece, we are simply winning. Okay, now look at this last position. Let's see what is overloaded here. Okay, I think the king is overloaded here. Is guarding this square also, guarding this square also. Both the means, like he is not allowing the rook also to give check, not allowing the queen also give the check to do something. So therefore, let's sacrifice this. Then we will give the queen check. Now king is only having option of going back. We will make queen and we will take this rook. If king comes down, then we can take this rook and we will win. So I hope you are completely understood both the concepts of like double check as well as overload pieces. Okay, so tomorrow again I will come with some new video. So before leaving, just subscribe and like this video. Thank you.